Hello everyone, Ranjita here, and I'm back again with some craft inspiration. Transferred sheets are the new trend, and today I'm here to show you how to use them on fabric along with loads of ideas, tips and tricks. I'm going to show you how to use supplies like clear stamps, stencils and inks on fabric. So without any delay, let's get started. For the first project today, I am using this transferred sheet in the design African. The best part of these transferred sheet is that behind each sheet you get a QR code that leads you to a detailed video tutorial, and also you have a photo inspiration here that shows you how to use these transferred sheets. Along with these images, I am having a very thin cotton fabric here. I prefer you use cotton fabric when you are trying to use these transfer images on fabric, because cotton absorbs the water and gives you best results when you try to use these transferred images. I am carefully fussy cutting the image that I want to transfer. Make sure that you cut it as close as possible. Here you can see I've cut out a piece of fabric, and I've also folded the edges so that I have a much neater look. Now I'm just roughly placing my design and I'm checking out the alignment. You can see there is a clear film here. You need to peel it off and then carefully place it upside down on the fabric. Once placed is placed for all, so make sure you place it exactly the way you want, because once you place it you cannot move it anymore. Once I have placed it upside down, I am taking a sponge, dipping it in clean water and then dabbing the wet sponge on the image. Dab the water until you can see the image through the thing, that is, there is no white patches on the image that you have just placed. Once your image is completely soaked, you can see you can carefully peel off the backing here. That's it, your image is transferred. Now to enhance this little tag that I'm trying to make, I'm playing around with my clear stamps. So yes, you can use your clear stamps on fabric, but make sure that you have enough juicy ink pad with you, and you also place the stamp on the fabric for a good time so that you can transfer it well. So here you can see I have used archival jet black ink to stamp my clear image. Now I am taking a sheet of burlap along with a sheet of felt. Now to make it look like a tag, I am just chopping off the corners of the felt here. This is a very, very simple tag. You can make it in very less time. All you need is some scrap pieces of fabric. Here I am using burlap and felt to give a backing and some strength to my fabric. However, it is entirely optional. You can use two layers of fabric if you do not have burlap or felt. Once I am happy with the placement, I am going to give a stitch all around it. You can also use hot glue to place them. That's it. Our first tag is ready. Now coming to the second one, I am using this succulent image here, and I am using a little drawstring pouch that I have stitched myself. As you can see here, I have also fussy cut this image. All I will be doing is I will again be peeling off this clear film here. Be careful while you are handling your image. Don't try to smudge on the image, because you will not get proper transfer if you have fingerprints. Then again, I'm repeating the same process. I'm dipping a clean sponge in water and I'm soaking the image, making sure that there are no white patches left. Once you soak the paper, your image is instantly transferred. This is very, very addicting. Once you start using these transfer sheets, you will make so many projects because they're very addicting. Like I did for the first project, I'm again playing around with my clear stamps, and I'm using my archival jet black ink. And I'm carefully stamping over my fabric, making sure I'm giving it enough time for the image to get stamped properly on the cloth. This is looking beautiful as it is, but I'm using this stencil from Craft Angles here, and again some archival ink, and then just inking over the borders here just to add some interest to the pouch here. You can might as well use paints, but I have a lot of inks in my stash, and I prefer using inks because they give a very thin layer of color on my fabric, whereas paints often add dimension to your projects. So this is a very quick and easy way, no hassle, no drying time absolutely, So try using your inks on your fabric as well. They are archival and they are permanent. So don't hesitate on using these archival inks on your fabric projects as well. So here you can see our drawstring pouch is ready. Very, very simple and beautiful, isn't it? Now let's move ahead and make the next project. For the next project, I'm making a tag here. I've cut out this mannequin image here. I've again fussy cut it carefully so that I do not have any excess. Then I'm carefully peeling off the clear plastic here. And then I'm placing it on a watercolor paper. This is very, very important. You need to use a good quality watercolor paper. Don't try to use it on regular paper or cardstock. Cardstock or regular paper cannot take water and they will start ripping off. So make sure you use a good quality watercolor paper. So once my image is transferred, I just wanted to add some hint of color here and there. So again, I've brought out my archival inks in a different shade here this time. And I'm just adding hint of color on the borders just to give it a little vintage or rusty look here. This step is entirely optional, but however, I preferred to add a little color and that brought in so much more depth to this image. So now that my image is transferred and I have inked the borders, I've taken a scrap piece of net fabric here. I'm adding some hot glue near the waist of this mannequin and I'm just forming rough pleats with my fabric. Every time I form a pleat, I'm just adding a little bit of hot glue, just a drop of it. Make sure you have your fingers protected. Don't try to press it over hot glue. So as you can see here, I'm just forming rough pleats. So this would make a beautiful skirt for my mannequin. Just a little bit of fabric onto this card has brought in so much more beauty to this simple mannequin image. I just loved how it is turning out. So once I am happy with everything, I am just adding some artificial flowers just to cover up the rough edges of the net here. Oh, this is looking so pretty. This would be a perfect gift tag for a beautiful girl or for a bride. Now, just like the other projects, you can leave it as it is, but I just wanted to add some more strength to this simple watercolor paper. So I'm adding a sheet of burlap and then a sheet of cardstock to add a hint of color and to bring all of this together. So this finishes another beautiful tag. Now let's move ahead to the last project. This is a little lengthy but definitely interesting and you can make so many beautiful projects with just this simple technique. So again, I'm starting with some transparent images. This time I'm taking this cute kitty here. And then I'm using a circular base here. This is a jewelry earring base. However, you can use a button or you can also cut out a thick cardboard in the same size. But make sure that the size of the base that you're taking is slightly larger than your image. I've also cut out a piece of fabric. This is roughly double the diameter of the base that you're taking. I hope I'm clear. You need to take a base that is slightly larger than your image and then you need to take your cloth piece slightly or double the size, the diameter of your base. You will understand as I progress into the video. So as you can see here, I am just going through a running stitch all around the border of the circle that I have cut out here. I'm a little off focus here, but all I'm doing is I'm having a gathering stitch or a running stitch all around the border of my circular fabric that I have cut out. You do not need to have any super duper sewing skills here. All you need to do is just have a running stitch. And then I'm slowly pulling the thread here so that it'll form a cup-like shape here. I hope you can understand. First, I have made a running stitch all along the border of the circular fabric and then I'm slightly cinching it up so that it forms a cup-like shape. Then I'm taking my base and I'm placing some cotton beneath it and I'm then cinching it up properly. I'm adding cotton here because I wanted to have some volume to my button. Once you're happy with the shape of the button, all you need to do is secure the fabric behind the button by tying up a knot You can also run a stitch couple of times so that your button is secured. This is the reason I asked you to take double the size the fabric so that your button looks neat at the back as well. So with this, we finish making a fabric button. Now that our fabric button is ready, I'm taking this cute kitty. I'm again peeling off the clear cling film that is on the image. I'm carefully placing it on the button. Here I want to mention a point. In case if you're trying to make fabric buttons and then transfer an image onto the fabric button, make sure that you transfer the image after you make the button. Do not try to transfer image onto fabric and then try to make a button, because when you stretch the fabric while making the button, you will end up tearing and forming creases on your image as well. So now that I have transferred my image onto the button, I am again taking a small piece of fabric here. I have made a tube out of it. I am again running a stitch all along the length of the fabric. Here I am trying to make a very, very simple yo-yo flower. This was a very, very simple project. In this, I wanted to show you how you can make some beautiful flowers or roses with some scrap fabric. Instead of making such flowers, you can might as well use the fabric buttons as it is. You can hot glue them onto clips or any other bases and use them. But here I wanted to take you one step ahead and show you how you can make a very, very simple rosette flower. You call this a yo-yo flower. All you need is a long piece of fabric. You have to do a gathering stitch all along the length, and then you have to pull it together to form a flower. Once you're happy with the shape of the flower, just secure both the edges together so you have a flower here. I am now taking some hot glue gun and I am placing this fabric button on the center of the fabric flower that I have made. So this is a very, very simple version of making your own matching flower for your kids' dresses. They would definitely love if you make some pretty flowers here with some cute images. So you can directly place them onto a hairband like this. You can secure them with a piece of felt. Or here I am using a hair tie and I am securing it with a piece of felt. This is a very, very simple way of making a hair accessory in your matching fabric. However, you can make such flowers and place them onto pins or stick them onto alligator clips. The kids would love to have them as beautiful hair accessories. However, if you just make these fabric buttons, you can also stick them onto your kids' frocks. They would look beautiful as it is. So here was a very, very simple version on how you can make some beautiful matching fabric accessory. So this was my inspiration for today. You can see the close-up images of all the finished projects here. This was my take on how you can use transferred sheets and beautiful images onto fabric. I've shared some simple but unique ideas. I hope you like them and you will also definitely give them a try. I hope you like today's project. If you make something similar or you're inspired by any of my videos, don't forget to share your projects with me and tag me on your social media. I would love to see your take on my inspiration. That's it for today's video. If you want to make something similar, all the products are linked in the description box below. Make sure to check out the website as well. Thank you so much for stopping by. I will be back soon with some more crafty inspiration. Until then, bye.